gutted. Honest to God, you know what? I sat there before the game and I was with everyone. And I said, I don't have much belief in it because it's City. They're that good. And I was hoping to God that they put three past them in the first 15. I just didn't want them to give me hope. And when Felipe Coutinho, of all people, puts them 2-0 up, I start to dream. And you know what? That's the one thing you can't do as a Liverpool fan. It's the one thing they don't let you do. Gundogan, he's off in the summer. Why is he bothered? He's off in the summer. It doesn't matter. Goes up and pops up with two. Rodri from the edge of the box. Robin Olsen, before the game, I was fuming that he was playing. He put in a masterclass for 76 minutes and then just decided, oh, yeah, I'm a former Everton player. You don't want Liverpool to win the league. Let's put three in. And then the icing on the cake, the cherry on top, the moment that Silky Ilky scores his third, Mo Salah decides, oh, I know how to score goals. Let me just kick it in the back of the net and just rub it in even more. Now, I'm not saying that us scoring earlier on would have changed how it went, but it would have done my heart a lot better because you know what? I was sat there in that second half believing. The one thing I didn't want to do, I was believing. And it hurt in the end. It really hurt in the end.
A lot of people in the comments, though, Tom, are saying Slippy G all over again.
It happened again.
apparently, he took off. Who did he take? He made a bad sub. Apparently, Gerrard. He took off one of his best. I weren't watching it, obviously. But he took off one of his best players. At the end of the day, while it's annoying, it is annoying that you know Villa couldn't see it through. It's on us. It should never come down to relying on other teams to win a title. We've got to look back at ourselves. We've had some awful results this season that have cost us. Brentford, 3-3. Brighton, 2-2. They are shocking results that have cost us in the grand scheme. It doesn't matter as much in November or October when it happens because you sat there going, oh, it doesn't matter. They'll drop points. But we're dealing with two of the best Premier League teams of all time. They've made 10-game winning runs a normality. So we've got to start... Now with this team, with this club, we've got to start not throwing away results early on in the season, going, oh, it doesn't matter. It'll catch them out later on. Because as you've seen, it just doesn't. It doesn't.
I hear you on that. Lias, how do you think that Liverpool are going to bounce back? Obviously, they've got a big game next Saturday, Champions League final, because they did look deflated at the end there.
Yeah, I mean, they got the two goals at the end, but I think I kind of disagree with you when you say, would those two goals have meant anything? I think they do. I think football is so much about mentality. You score, you go ahead, news goes to the Etihad, all of a sudden panic sets in even more. But listen, I think you're being a bit harsh on your team, to be honest, because you dropped points early on in the season. City dropped a few points near the end. This is it. This is a 38-game campaign. So at the end of the day, the best team always wins. I always agree, say it.
And... I'll throw the cereal.
Go ahead.
Do Man City draw 2-2 with Brighton or 3-3 with Brentford?
Well, they drew West Ham.
West Ham are a European team. Brentford are 12th. Brighton are 10th.
I get your frustration. And I feel like you're...
City lost to Palace twice this season.
Yeah, I feel like you're nitpicking slightly. And I get where you're coming from. We're going to go and speak to a... Who are we going to speak to? Which Liverpool fan is it? Motts. If he gets off... Who are we speaking to? You can speak. I don't know who we're speaking to. We're going to speak to a Liverpool fan. Let's go over to Colleen.
Here we are at Unit 7, lads. Lads. Motts especially.
Jurgen Quad.
Sometimes, you know, you have to take an L. Obviously, again, Jurgen Quad stocks have plummeted to a whopping zero. But I checked out when City were 2-0 up. So, you know, I got my money back. No. Listen, seriously, though, listen. I think we gave it a good go. I think if we didn't win today what we drew, then I would have been even more angry. But I think the fact that City come back within, 6 minutes... That's the stuff of champions, isn't it? If you can come back from 2-0 down to 3-2 in the space of 10 minutes to win you the champ, to win you the league, you just got to hold your hands up.
And I'm not liking this humility. Rax, come talk to me. You were here with all of us elated that City turned it around. Talk to me. How are you feeling?
Well, I mean, they did say that everyone supports Liverpool, apparently. Pep Guardiola said that. If you were in this room right now, you would not see it because literally everybody else was cheering for City. So... Is what it is. Look, I'm proud of the team. I'm proud of how we performed this season. I know what Tom was saying about individual games. Sometimes you lose some, you draw some. That happens in football. I'm just proud of the team. We go again next week and we win Champions League. We win number seven.
This is a Real Madrid fan cam channel starting.
I get Liverpool fans are frustrated. We're going to go to some of your super chats now.